Boo, scared you. Just kidding. Let's draw Ahh Real Monsters. Today, tonight, this evening, whenever you're watching this, we are going to be drawing Ahh Real Monsters, which was a Nickelodeon show in the 90s. Maybe you've heard of it. I didn't really like it, but I drew it because a lot of people asked me to. The characters are sick. Crumb, Oblina, and Ickis. So I'm going to show you how I sketch the characters, very much drawing in my style. I am using Adobe Illustrator and Photoshop. Then I take that sketch, I bring it into Illustrator, I trace all the shapes, and then I take a simple color palette and I just color drop, like it's MS Paint. Then we bring it over to Photoshop where we do some texturing. In this video, I tried to cover texturing a little bit more. And just to remind you, like, the texturing process seems crazy. It's not. It's just bringing in things from Illustrator into Photoshop and just drawing on top of them, just like scribbling on top and maybe scanning in some textures and some papers or downloading them and then dropping them in. So for anyone that's not familiar, these are the characters that from like a 95, 97. Anyway, the idea is basically that like Crumb is a circle. Ickis is like a triangle with like this type of a shape with big ears. I think they always like mistook him for a rabbit, which was funny because he's supposed to be scary and he wouldn't be. And then you have Crumb who has like hands like this with eyeballs, little legs. Oblina is like this basically with the tail. And then like little arms and eyes like this. So I'm gonna sketch and maybe I'll talk through it as much as I can.
Okay, surprise, I am talking through it. My main point to this clip is just that I'm undoing often and like I'm also not getting the perfect sketch. That's not really important yet. I'm just getting ideas onto paper, so to speak.
For anyone asking or anyone curious, I am drawing on a Wacom Cintiq and then I'm using a MacBook Pro up above that's connected to it. And then Oblina is like this candy cane, basically. And a lot of my work's gonna be done in Illustrator anyway, so I'm just getting the sketch kind of close enough. I think my Crumb could be a lot better. I'm gonna lower my brush size a touch more and just draw again.
Often with these types of sketches, I'm trying to hide my source material as quickly as I can. That way I start getting more and more unique results by just not looking at the reference after a certain amount of time.
I'm feeling decent about Crumb. I gotta do better. Ickis.
Hey, what up? It's Martin Scorsese, good friend of Kirk's. Just wanted to quickly chime in with some director's commentary and let you know that you're all very fortunate that you get to watch this video. And that's it. Thanks.
There's Ickis. Let's move Ickis to a final sketch. Like, that's cool with me. I'm good with that for Ickis. And I like this Crumb. I like, now that I'm looking back at them, I like all the Crumbs. And now Oblina, just, I gotta draw her again.
I'm not talking through this one. This one is gonna be music. La, 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 la.
Rearrange him a little bit so he's not quite so horribly drawn. So now I have my sketch decently done, good enough. Again, like my sketches are usually not fantastic. They're just like information that I need in order to bring it into Adobe Illustrator and then play around with shapes, which is where we're gonna have a decent amount of fun. I'm gonna start with this Crumb. So I just set my opacity low and lock the layer and then make a new layer on top. And I'm just gonna use a black stroke and just go through and get all my shapes and not really worry about color at all yet.
You'll notice I add a lot of extra points, maybe even unnecessarily, and that's just a way for me to get the vectors to look a little bit more organic and wonky. But you know, ideally I'm still balancing like as few points as I can, but still trying to add enough that it doesn't feel too geometric.
I try to make a lot of my shapes as separate shapes or objects as I can, that way I can modify them a little bit more easily down the line. So like this bit and this bit are separate. And then this, I'm gonna overlap the whole thing and I'm gonna make a copy of it. So there's two of these and then take this shape and the other one and use the pathfinder down here, which you can't see, but I'm doing the intersect. That way it cuts it out like that.
Yo, it's me. I'm Adam Sandler, the Sandman from Boston, probably. Anyway, Kirk's just doing a little bit of Pathfinder with this, and maybe he'll make a YouTube short just on this specific thing, but, you know, Pathfinder, Shape Builder, those great, great tools. Good comedy.
Vectoring Oblina. I just not sure if I want to vector this one up top instead. This one's great, too.
Oh, it's me, Tyler the Creator. I hope you like my new music. Kirk's a good friend of mine and he's using the Pathfinder Fuck, these are getting dull. I'm running out of things, guys. Sorry.
So next step is going to be basically taking these outlines that are a little bit wonky. What I do is I add a white fill to all the shapes. That way I can see what's in front and what's behind, like layering, and then rearrange them. Then I'll drop in color. And the color is really simple. I just have a color palette that I grab. Like I said, I'm just going to fill them all the same red. And then I go to my fill them white, and then come in and just cut and paste in front and back.
I'm only 5 minutes into this video and I'm already kind of sick of doing the voiceover thing, so I'm probably not going to do this next time. The time lapse is cool. Let me know if you'd like the time lapse. Do I have to talk over it? Can I just put music? Like, you tell me.
So when it comes to coloring, I basically always try to start with the things that I know first. So like his skin tone is going to be like this, and I'm just taking the eyedropper and dropping it in for all the colors that I know. And I'm just going to like color block quickly just so I can see if it's working or not.
Okay, here's an actual cool tip. If you have the eyedropper to like grab color, you can also hold down Alt and it will cast the color onto a shape, so it can push and pull.
One of my favorite parts is basically I'm gonna make some shadows to help separate, because I don't do outlines with my work very often at all. But what I do is I create shadows to give a sense of depth and contrast that's really needed. Now it looks like his arm is actually like interacting with himself, and I'm gonna make these shadows red. And then his little leggies are gonna cast, or his body is gonna cast shadow onto his legs, I think. This, yeah.
This is one of my favorite parts because I've already got the shapes figured out. Like, I know the silhouette's going to work, I know the colors are generally going to work, so I get to just basically noodle. I think for maybe some types of artists, like, this is like the rendering of the hair, the charcoal, but for me it's like adding little shadows.
Okay, so after a little bit of tinkering, I've got my characters where I want them. They're vectored in Illustrator, and now the next step we're going to do is we're going to copy and paste them into Photoshop and do a little bit of texturing, and I'll show you how I do it. It's really simple. It's basically just a couple brushes, some clipping masks, layer masks, and some like scanned textures that you set to like multiply at the end. So here on my screen, I'm in Photoshop here. I'm gonna go, these are my final characters that I've laid out. I've changed them a little bit. Really at this point, basically it depends on how much fidelity you want with your textures. If you want a texture like every arm and every leg, then you copy and paste the arms and the legs all in separately over to Photoshop. Because I'm gonna do something kind of quick, I'm just gonna copy all the characters together and then go to Photoshop and paste. And what I want to do is I want to paste this smart object. You could totally paste as layers, which is great and it's new. I just don't do it much, but it's a really great tool. But I'm going to paste this smart object. And the nice thing about the smart object is I can always go back to it and make a modification. Let's say I wanted to change this hair on Crumb. I can double click the thumbnail here and it will open me back up into Illustrator. I can make some sort of a modification, like make that there and maybe just move this chin in a little bit. I save it, Command S, and then when I go back to Photoshop, it updates. So you can see it updated. The way that I would typically do this particular drawing is, because my colors are so simple, I'm gonna make new groups. Group for all my colors. So I just selected all the red, go to this group, I'm gonna name it red, and I'm gonna make it a mask. That way, if I draw anything inside of this red layer, let's say I take a hot pink all over, right? As long as I draw it into that red layer, it will only paint inside of the red. The nice thing is I can make multiple layers inside that.
I'm just doing the same situation with the red, but I'm doing it for all of the colors and adding them to groups and adding masks.
And in fact, I'm gonna not be doing coloring in the lines first. What I wanna do is I wanna grab my black and I wanna draw on top of all of these, because I don't love the look of vector line work. So what I'm gonna do is just draw over a lot of them just to get a little bit of a brushy feel. And now if I go to my double click into my thing and I double click into Crumb, I can select all similar and grab all of these lines and delete them and then say save. And then when I pop back, it deletes all those underlying lines that were there, but because I drew on top of them, I'm good. And I can go through and do that with all of this. So this, I'm basically just taking this black line and just drawing over it.
Hey, it's me, Dochi. Grr. Did you like my Tiny Desk concert? Well, I'm here to tell you about Kirk's favorite part of the process, and it's called, everything is basically done and you just get to doodle on top of stuff and not really stress. And this is definitely my favorite part. Anyway, bye.
And if I jump back to my screen, you can see how this is looking. And then what I can do is I can also make a new layer and maybe grab like a red and fill it with option backspace, and then go up to filter, noise, add noise, something like a really small amount of noise, maybe 15%. And if I set that to something like overlay and then drop the opacity down a ton, what you get is this like really subtle noise. Turn it on and off, you'll see. And because it's a red, it warms the whole image up a little bit too. Just ever so slightly, it kind of harmonizes it or ties it all together, almost like you would do like a watercolor wash or an underbase with a painting. It kind of acts like that. Obviously, if I turn it up a little bit more, you can see it's really washing it. Okay, so here's like a photocopy texture that I purchased. And what I can do is basically just grab that and drop it into my canvas. And it'll plop it in. I can resize it. They're really big. And if I change that to something like multiply or color burn, overlay often is really helpful. You kind of just cycle through the blending modes and see what's working for you. And you can really dial this in with like certain levels and really get nerdy with it. But for the sake of this, you know, demonstration, I guess, I'm just going to probably do overlay and then lower the opacity a bunch. Turn them on and off. You see, it's just like adding a little bit of grit, grain, texture, toothiness, color. One other thing that I often do is I make a color balance on the top. And I just take all of my shadows, I make them a little bit cooler by bringing up the blue, turning down the green, and adding a little bit of cyan to it. I take my highlights, make them a little bit warmer. So bringing up some of the reds, similarly dropping, always dropping the greens. One more thing that we can do is go to filter, blur gallery, field blur. Field blur is fun. And you start like dropping points of like extreme blurs in different areas. And as you move them around, you can get like a crazy amount of blur in certain areas. If you wanted to really like blur certain parts like that. Just to, again, like give it something interesting and unique. And then you got like this cool blurred effect. And that's that. That's how I get all of my texture in there, all my toothiness, all my grit, my grain. Okay, that's like a way less, I think this one's not as entertaining as the other one, but hopefully it's more informative. There was a lot of questions of like how I do a lot of the stuff in my last video. But please ask me questions in the comments if you have them. Let me know what you want me to draw next, and I'm very open to whatever. Hair is what I want to do next, but I also want to do what you guys think. So if it's Rugrats, if it's Ahh Real Monsters, those are both ones I've already done. If it's, fuck, I don't know what else there was. Please subscribe. We're on the mighty road to 1,000 subscribers. We're at 700 as of recording this. This video is also an hour long. I have to edit this thing down. I hope that this format works. I hope you enjoy it. If you enjoy it, subscribe, like it, leave comments. I'd like to do more of this stuff. Anyway, love you so much. Gotta go. It's fucking freezing in the barn. God have mercy on my soul. God have mercy on your soul. Please let us all pray. Okay. Pray for me. Okay, good night. Good morning. Goodbye.